The story so far. I can't believe it. My mission was supposed to be routine data recovery on an old derelict generation ship, but instead, I ended up rescuing an adorable AI girl who grew up in a tremendously patriarchal Neo-Confucian society. And now she's discovered a bunch of messages left by the mysterious old mute, and wants me to uncover with her the slow enactment of a regressive political program that caused her society to regress to Joseon Dynasty social mores? I wasn't expecting this at all. I thought the 3-day trip back to Earth would be peaceful and lonely and not at all filled with reading about tragedy. And so began my hateful days. So that is the introduction to Hate Plus, the sequel to Analog, A Hate Story. I believe, based on that, I think it takes place right after the end of the first game. In fact, it even uses the save games from the first game. And I think it is takes place on the trip, well, back to Earth, as you're coming back from the Mugunghwa. I'm so freaking excited to play this! Yes, 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 yes. I get to see Hyun-ae again, oh yes! And maybe there's gonna be more cosplays and I get to play more dress up, and oh my god, it's gonna be so fun! And of course, filled with horrible tragedy. As always, a mixture of horribleness and utter cuteness. Actually, there's something I really like about the description for the game. Let me bring it up in Steam. Oh yes, so here it is. I love this part of the description for the game. A dark visual novel about transhumanism, cosplay, cake baking, and the slow patriarchal erosion of freedoms taken for granted. Cosplay, cake baking. Hell yes. I'm excited. And just listen to how awesome this music is. I like the music in the last game, but I like this even more. Yeah, I freaking love the music in this game. Okay, let's go. Hate Plus. So, continue will use your past save game. So, here's the last save game. The investigator, an unmarried man who misses Earth, returns home with a love-struck Hyun-ae, who feels strongly that her love is true. Okay, let's go. And she's wearing the scientist costume! Oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Jeez, I'm so sorry. Wait, what? Sorry about what? If you're saying something to me, I can't hear you at all. Wait a minute, are you kidding me? Am I still going to have to communicate to her using binary responses? Oh jeez, I'll explain. I tried installing that advanced dictionary you got for me. Okay. And, I couldn't get it to work. Even the builds that were supposed to be fine just kept giving me an architecture not supported error. I don't know why. So I tried to recompile my language processing functions so I could support it, but I don't really understand how AIs work very well, I guess. Anyway, what I'm trying to say is, I guess I sort of just broke it more. It's even more broken than before? Oh no. Like I said before, if you're saying anything, I can't hear you. And every time I try to run an English to Korean translation, it just comes out as nonsense. For example, if I try to translate your ship's name from English, I get... which I can't really understand, and neither can I. It's just like before when I was back on the Mugunghwa and I couldn't parse what you were saying. Sorry, are you mad at me? I have 3 options instead of 2? Oh my god. Well, this is new. No, I'm not mad at you. I wouldn't say it doesn't matter, it doesn't matter. I'm just sorry too. Thanks. I'm glad you understand. We'll be able to get it fixed once we get to Earth, right? Right? Of course. I don't actually know, but yes. Keep hope alive, of course. That's a relief. I don't know what I'd do if this was permanent. Well, I waited over 600 years to meet you, didn't I? That is very true. 3 days? That's nothing. Anyway, there's something else you should know. While I was looking through my code, trying to debug my damage, I found a big block of data that I thought was garbage. It's not garbage, though. It's data. For some reason, it seems to be embedded in my source. I'm not really sure why. It's not part of my memories, it's in the actual machine code for some reason. The important thing is, though, I think it's log files from the Mugunghwa. They have date stamps on them, and they seem to be from before the year zero. Well, I can't actually read them without extracting them, but that's what the index says. Ooh. So yeah, I think this game is all about discovering what happened before the year zero, what happened leading up to the year zero, because if you remember, none of the logs I ever read were from before year zero, and year zero was when everything was reset. Like, at some point, things went so horribly wrong that for some reason they decided to reset, I guess everything, and call it year zero. They wanted to start again. And I have no idea what happened, but I think we're going to find out. It's really exciting. What happened in year zero that made everyone forget? It was always the big mystery to me. Maybe these will explain. Here's what I'm thinking. Maybe we can't communicate, but we could still go through these together. Or through those together. What do you think, Mr. Investigator? Can I be your sidekick again? Hyun-ae, of course you can be my sidekick. Of course. Yay, that's wonderful. Let's investigate them together. Oh my god, the look on her face is so adorable. Ah, she's so cute. Okay. Let me explain how this will work, then. I'm afraid I can't just extract all of them at once. I can explain if you want, but it's kind of boring. Explain anyway, I'm curious. Very well, I don't really understand this myself very well, so I'm sorry if I get some details wrong, but... Basically, the core AI code is designed to make it really difficult for AIs to make copies of themselves. So if I just copied all that log data out, the recompile script wouldn't work at all, since it would detect the duplicated code. Which means I'll have to copy them out, delete the parts that are actually in my code base, then recompile myself. But I don't want to delete more than a few at a time, because I'm scared that I might make a mistake. So I'm going to be super careful, no more than 6 files at a time, and my script's going to triple check that I'm not deleting something important by accident. Okay, sounds like a good idea. I'm down with that. It'll be way slower and probably take up a lot of power, because the virtual machine you're running me in is pretty inefficient, but... Well, better to be safe, right? Hell yes! Does that all make sense? Yep. Great. I think I used up most of today's power up running debugging, though. So we'll only be able to do a little bit, but there's always tomorrow. Anyway, I'll let you decide which log files you want to extract first. Then we can read them together. Okay, how is this gonna work? Alright, let me... Hey, could you click on me, please? Sure. Yay, it works! Oh my gosh, she's adorable. Right, very well. It's a little bit like on the Mugunghwa. I'll use that as an indicator that I want your attention. Alright. Well, that's all. Just click on me if you want to talk in the future. Anyway, let's get back to investigating together. Okay, so I can just mouse over her if I want to talk to her. Alright, let's take a look at all this information and figure out what I'm looking at. So, Starship White Princess. So that's the name of my starship. White Princess. It's an interesting name, because her name was the Pale Bride. White Princess. Huh. Anyway. It's also interesting that it keeps flashing. I hope that's intended. Maybe it's supposed to be like I'm looking at a kind of... I don't know, a... slightly malfunctioning console or something? Either way, it's not a big deal. PM, Monday, February 9th, is that the year? Is that the year 4989? Holy crap. Anyway, destination, ETA 3 days, Seoul 3. Okay. It's sorted in a very strange way, but I'm not gonna get bogged down in the dates and stuff. 25% power, ooh yeah, that is not much. Looks like that's the COM upload-download speed. ATM, something to do with oxygen. Not sure what that is. Ship is currently running in emergency power mode. Non-essential computer use quota in effect. My apologies for the trouble. Hyun-ae. Artificial investigator, Hyun-ae. Oh, I could just change her outfit right here. Okay, what can I change it to? Does she have anything new, or is it just the same stuff? Pale Bride. Would that be the Hanbok? It's gotta be the Hanbok. Yeah, I'm not gonna change it to that. Okay, I'm gonna leave her on Scientist, because that is my favorite. Alright, I've got one unread message. So how do I actually look at documents? I don't know, let's check the unread messages. White Princess Inbox. Regarding Hardshell Inquiry, Wong Robotics, February 9th, 4000... That's weird. It just kind of flash. I guess it turns blue when you mouse over it. February 9th, 4989. Alright, what is this? So, you're interested in purchasing a hardshell frame for an AI construct. We've evaluated your questionnaire, and we've attached a pamphlet for a model which we think will suit your needs. Marigold 89 Hardshell Frame. Marigold is our mainstay animation-inspired model for classic feminine presentation. For the happening construct that requires both close human integration and elegance in all things. In a marigold frame, you can start the day with a cup of tea, coffee would be too vulgar, in the morning, feel the breeze in your hair in the afternoon, go out dancing, ballroom of course, the night away, and then finish with a graceful peck on the cheek of your dancing partner. Oh sweet, I can use the scroll wheel, instead of having to press the next button, that's nice. Full sensory feedback. We guarantee each Marigold frame's visual slash audio slash tactile slash olfactory has been triple tested thoroughly to register at least 95% of standard human resolution. Of course, Marigold is compatible with all hard shell sensory systems, so whether it's for stargazing nebulae with your sweetheart, or appreciating strawberry crepes, I think they're called, more thoroughly, we have you covered. The face that launched 1,000 starships. As with all hardshell models, we offer fully customizable facial designs, and 12 months of free hairstyle reconfigurations with purchase. But Marigold's facial range goes above and beyond expectations. With his animation-inspired exaggerated features, you'll actually boast an even wider range of expressions than a typical human. From the subtlety of a coy smile, to heartfelt shouting, to the slight twinkle in your eyes of happiness. In Marigold, we promise you'll be able to inspire the... That... What is the hell? Yuki... Waku waku feeling in anyone? What the fuck? I have no idea what yuki yuki waku waku means. What? Okay. Newly upgraded. Of course, what makes the 89 model of Marigold truly special are the additional features. The state-of-the-art Dream Machine GPU allows for perfect recollection of your most treasured memories. The patented Real Tears system allows for a revolutionary wide range of expressions of despair. A revolutionary wide range of expressions of despair. Great. Plus, the all-new Wonder Arm functionality will allow you to easily grab faraway teacups without even unruffling your skirt. Truly, the Marigold 89 Hardshell Frame is the model for the happening feminine animation-loving AI construct. Please contact us for further purchase details. All our models are highly affordable. We're looking forward to hearing back from you on Earth. I don't know if that sounds great or really creepy. Yeah. How do I go... Oh, return to menu. Actually, can I use the back button on my mouse? No, I can't. Oh well. Not a big deal. Oh yes, and I need to remember the save thing. Do not go to the menu first. Go to the options and create new save file. There we go. Okay. Now, again, do I... I think she said we used up the power for the day, right? So I can't read any more, or what? Let me talk to her. Oh, I guess I can't talk to her. What do I do? Do I have to disable her? I don't really want to. I don't think there's anything else I can do, though, so I guess I will. Disable active AI. Emergency diagnostic and extract new messages. Okay, so I can extract some more. Right, so I have to disable her before I can read. That makes sense. Emergency diagnostic. What is that? Performing diagnostic on AI construct, Hyun-ae. No errors found. Okay, cool. That didn't take up power, did it? No. Okay. Let's take a look. Let's get investigating. Alright, 25% power. Currently operating in emergency power mode, processing power only available to extract 6 files at a time. Okay, wow, that is a lot. Bad data, no data, bad data, bitmap data. So I guess that's an image. Whoops, I didn't mean to click that. What did I just do? What did I just do? What did I just click? I have no idea what I just clicked. Let's go back. I clicked on this, but it seemed to just... Anyway, it doesn't seem like I can click it because it doesn't light up. So I need to choose six that I want. Block M4, M1, M1. Does any sort of an order matter? Alright, Records Office Amendment of the Education Act. Let's crush rebellion from mute. That sounds good. Let's grab that. Alright, so I'm gonna commit to extraction. So let's pick everything first. Smith, efficient and subtle. Let's take a look at stuff from block M1, because I'm guessing that would be earlier on or something. Efficient and subtle. Hyo Sung Bok. Election night. Election night. Big political stuff, could be important. Hyo Seo Young. Elegance in her cat-like grin. I want the big stuff, so I know what the hell happened. Again, I'm looking for M1. Daily report for March 15th. Let's grab that, it's from block 1. Monthly rendezvous in the dark. I hate the mornings after. Especially looking at M1. Fuck Hyo family gather. Fuck Hyo family gatherings. Whoa, I'm gonna grab that one, that sounds interesting. That boy. Fired. Not a lot of M1. Please talk to me, Mimi. That's another one from Mute. You know, I'm just gonna go with M1. Let's just go with M1. Just grab some M1. I'll just grab some random smatterings, and I'm sure it'll give me an idea of where to go next. Amendment of the Education Act. I'm really curious about that one. Alright, let's get rid of that one, and let's grab this Efficient and Subtle from M1 and this, the Education Act. That sounds big. Okay, let's commit to extraction. Cool. It's really cool, you actually get to see it happen. Neat. And there goes my power. It's a shame I can't have Hyun-ae with me as I'm doing this, because unfortunately she has to be disabled. I guess you can say I turn Hyun-ae off. Yeah, you get it? I turn her off because I disabled her, because I was... the data files and... yeah. Anyway. Okay. Let's look at the dates here. Alright. 4,000... Jesus. So this is obviously all from before it reset to the year 0. 4038, 4042, 42, 38, 42, 38. So let's stick with stuff around the same time. In the same year, at least. Let's go with this. Yeah, because this is the earliest, in terms of year, and also the one I want to look at the most. Let's crush rebellion. 4038 from Mute. Mute! Apparently she has something to say about this. Well, hold on, let me read it first. Oh boy, this is long. I don't really see how that's a crisis. Wait, what are you talking- hold on, let me catch up. How- oh, whoa, there's clickable links within the file? Okay. From Mute, from my internal logs, 7:20 p.m. in the Hyo household, during our daily meeting. How are you, Miss Hyo? I asked. Seo Young, after showing up on her living room computer screen, her very first words after, "Good morning, good evening, counselor," were, "I'm having a major crisis with my husband." It didn't seem like she was very serious, which is good, since I kinda like him. "Go on," I said. "You've heard of those fashionable paper lanterns, right? The ones that are genuine paper? They're sold in the upper court plaza?" "Not really, no." "Well, they let through this gorgeous red light." I interrupted her with a, "Yes, I know what paper lanterns are like, so what's the crisis?" "Don't you think they'd be perfect for the living room?" My husband objects, because they cost about 50,000 silver per. He thinks it's too extravagant. She said, whatever that means. Does that man have any idea how much money you make? I asked. She replied, I don't think so. You know how men are. Of course, Mr. Kim is the kind to get jealous of his wife making more money than him, which is pretty silly. He's merely a teacher, and Seo Young is the Counselor of Security's top lieutenant. He needs to get over it. I said pretty much that to her. I don't know. I think this extremely minor dispute about interior decorating may be fatal to our relationship. If we get a divorce, can I sleep in your home? I was about to say something, but I got cut off by one of our young maids suddenly popping up to deliver tea. Thanks, Miss Lim, said Seo Young, dismissing her. You know you already sleep in my home, right? I responded once the girl left. With all due respect, counselor, she said, this is my home. How do you figure that? I told her. Only because I bought it for your great-great-great-grandfather. I don't think you would have liked the old place. I think you have closets in this place bigger than it was. Not much room for those servants, either. Oh wow, leave it to Mute to remember a debt for... She paused, counting it on her fingers. Centuries? That would be 200 years ago. It's not that long, I told her. She was amused. You're awfully old, she said. Hold on, she just said, how old I wonder. You're awfully old, she said. I replied, but you're still just a young girl. Wait, hey, is that a gray hair I see? She protested in disbelief, but I didn't even have to make it up. She totally is starting to go gray. I mean, she's like 38, so it's hardly strange. No way, she said, getting bothered. Maybe I'll stay with my husband after all. You're mean. Because he's too nice to make fun of your childish response to aging, I asked. No, she said, because he's got terrible eyesight. Okay, okay, I said, amused. Let's get to business, all right? She nodded, turning serious. What's the first order, then? Well, wanna crush a rebellion? I asked. She got excited again. Do I ever? Can we actually do that? She asked, but with a smile on her face at the thought of it. These democracy agitators have been causing no end of stress for the past, what, 2 years? I bet they're the cause of this gray hair. She paused, taking a sip of her tea. Can we destroy them? Please? Please? Scary. Democracy agitators. What's a democracy agitator? Well, okay, I've got an idea, and I think I can get Chief Counselor Smith and Counselor Yang on board pretty easily. Let's call it, how about Operation Get Back at the Idiots for giving the young Lady Chief Security Officer Hyo gray hair prematurely, I said. It was a joke, but, like, we both knew full well that the stakes here were pretty high. And this rebellion really has been starting to get dangerous. Oh yes, she said with a happy smile. This is the nicest gift you could have ever given me, Mute. Let's crush a rebellion. That's very strange. I can't grab this dot to go up and down. I can use the scroll wheel and I can click these, but I can't grab this. Weird. It also keeps pausing when I scroll for some reason. Very strange. Anyway. So what are all these links to? What do they do? How are you, Miss Hyo? Or maybe that's how. Might be pronounced how. Let's find out what this does. Oh, you actually get to see a picture of her. This is the first time we've read about this person. Click their name again in another log file and it'll remind you about them. Okay, so if you forget who someone is, you can get a reminder. Okay. So if I do this right now, it just... Okay. Seo Young. That is the same person. Yep. Seo Young Hao? Hyo? Whatever it is. Counselor. And this is the first time we've read about this person. Click their name again in another log file and I'll remind you about them. Wait, is that a picture of Mute? She looks different. Hold on, who's that? Counselor. After good evening, counselor, where I'm having a major crisis with my husband. Oh, wait a minute. I think this is from before she was an AI. Maybe? Showing up on her living room computer screen. Well, she could have just been going in with video, not necessarily an AI. I don't remember, because wasn't she not an AI forever? Wasn't she a person to begin with, and then she turned herself into an AI or something? I don't know, I don't remember. Major crisis with my husband. Okay, cool, so I actually have pictures. I actually have faces to put to the names. Interesting. That should make it a lot easier to remember who people are, that's really nice. My husband, yep, that's the same guy. Okay, cool. And that's the same, yep. Neat. Alright, let's see if there's anything new in here. Oh, that, Miss Lim. Miss Lim, she's one of Hyo Seo Young. God, I'm probably mispronouncing that so bad. Hyo Seo Young's maids. Counselor, mute. Yep. Yep. Smith, that's new. Chief Counselor Smith. Hello, you look very old. Yang. No photo on file. Hyo, yep, that's her again. Okay. Well, I think I've got a hang of the system. Let's go back. Alright, so again, we're trying to stick within the same year. So, the other ones from 38 are these two. Efficient and Subtle and Amendment of the Education Act. Let's go for the Amendment of the Education Act. Alright. Chief Counselor Smith. Alright, it's him. Smith was the Chief Counselor of the Mugunghwa. We have time for one more order of business today. Counselor O. It's Counselor O. No photo on file. Counselor O's proposed amendment of the Education Act. The text of it can be found in the third appendix of the session's agenda. I'll now leave the floor to remarks from Counselor O. Counselor O, Education. No remarks, it's just general housekeeping shit for the university. Well, that is very unprofessional language. General housekeeping shit. Okay, that's startlingly unprofessional. But I don't really care, just interesting. Counselor Mute, Security. Great, I'm going to abstain voting and decline to pay any more attention to this session, if that's okay with you. Counselor Smith, State. Counselor. Mute, Security. Okay, I'm gonna stop reading this State Security thing. Mute. It doesn't affect security, I vote don't care. Smith. Does the rest of the council object to bringing it to a vote? Ryu. Captain C. None here. Take a look at Ryu. Says Ryu... I don't remember his last name. I wanted to say Ryu Che Hua, but I know that's not him. That's his wife, I think? Anyway. Kim, Engineering and Science, I object. I don't understand the purpose of the proposed change about language rules. Is that really necessary? Oh. I don't think so. Kim, can you explain that? Oh. I don't understand what they're talking about. Hyun-ae, yeah, I don't know what they're talking about either. I guess I would need to read the actual act, amendment, to have any idea. Kim, can you explain that? Oh. It's just some minor changes to general requirements. Even engineers have general requirements, that's why they're called general. Mute. I don't think we needed the vocabulary lesson, Counselor. Smith. That's... Mute. Yes, I know, out of line, withdrawn. Kim. It doesn't sound like minor changes. Oh. This was all requested and drafted by Mugunghwa University President Oh... Yun... How do you pronounce that? Yun? Ian? Yun-ae? Oh, Yun-ae? I don't know. This is the first time we've read about this person? Alright, so apparently she is the university president. She assured me that it's just a minor change to allow for students to get a more rounded education. Kim, what exactly is more rounded about forcing engineers into pointless general classes? Oh, everyone already takes general classes, it's not... Lee. Oh, but learning Chinese characters is silly. Hyun-ae, I think you're a little bit ahead of me. Lee, you are new. No photo on file. Lee, pardon me if I may. Oh, certainly, I yield the floor to Counselor Lee. Lee, As I understand it, the change is to allow general programs to include texts written in Chinese characters. Is that right? Oh, that's what I'm told. Kim, meaning technical students will have to go out of their way to learn pointless nonsense that doesn't have anything to do with science. Lee, Chinese characters aren't taught in public school. Oh, that's right. Lee, and the other counselors see where this is going, yes? Does it really need to be spelled out why it would be a good thing to make the educational requirements for noble professions less accessible to any old peasant at a public school? Whoa, wait a minute, what? Does it really need to be spelled out why it would be a good thing to make the educational requirements for noble professions less accessible to any old peasant at a public school? Ah. So they're trying... Is that the angle they're taking with this? They're trying to keep the uneducated uneducated? And out of work, at least out of the noble professions? Jesus, that's fucking horrible. Mute. Whoa, Mute, back then, really was harsh. Mute, in case you haven't noticed, we have a serious problem with overeducated peasants already. Whoa. They agitate for democracy and give me a headache. Making things harder for them seems like preserving the status quo to me. Well, this makes me like Mute even less. Overeducated peasants already. They're agitating for democracy. Wow. Mute, you're a horrible person. It doesn't take a genius to see that trying to keep the peasants down and uneducated probably led to a bit of a political explosion, which probably led to Year Zero. Lee, that was my thinking. Oh, it's just housekeeping regardless. Kim, I still don't... Mute. Counselor Kim, do you really feel that strongly about this? Really? Lee, if you move to vote, I'll second it. Smith, do we have a motion to vote? Oh, I move to vote then. Lee, seconded. Smith, the motion passes. How does the council vote? O is in favor. Ryu is in favor. Cho is in favor? Who's Cho? No photo on file. Mute, the Counselor of Security, wants to get this over and done with, in favor. Yang. Counselor of Justice is in favor and agrees with the lovely Counselor of Security. Kim, ugh. Smith, ugh, is not a vote. Kim, fine. The Counselor of Engineering and Science abstains. I don't care that much. Lee, the Counselor of Culture, is in favor. Wow, so a motion that is basically designed to keep the peasants uneducated basically just passed unanimously. Wonderful. Smith, the Counselor of State, is also in favor. Smith, let the record show that the vote was 7 in favor with 1 abstention. The amendment passes and will go to the president for signing. With that, I move to close council for the day, to resume next Monday. Well, all right, says Hyun-ae. Mute, seconded, gladly. Smith, then the High Council of the Mugunghwa is dismissed. Well, things are obviously off to a bad start already, Jesus. Okay. Next one from that year is Efficient and Subtle from Smith. Alright, so once again, remind me who Smith is. Okay. Chief Counselor of the Mugunghwa. You know, I think adding in the ability to click on people's names and see their picture and remember who they are is one of the best features that she's added to this game. That is awesome. I have trouble keeping track of who people are. And being able to instantly have a description of who they are and being able to actually put a face to the name is really nice. Okay. Counselor Mute has once again tried my patience by requesting a meeting with me and Counselor Yang at a very specific time and location, then showing up late. Wait a minute, hold on. This must have been before Mute was an AI, right? Because if Mute can show up late, then, I mean, if she's an AI, then why would she ever be late? She wouldn't even need to physically be there. The subject was so important, I had no choice but to put up with it, but it doesn't mean I appreciate the utter lack of respect. She insisted on meeting in the Upper Plaza restaurant, Royal, and her lieutenant, Hyo, was the first there. Ah, yes, her. chief security officer, Mew's closest lieutenant. She was also married to Professor Kim. Chief security officer, okay. But it took the counselor herself a whole half an hour for her to finally show up on her private room screen. Oh no, okay, wow. She was late. And she was just appearing on the screen, she didn't even have to physically be there, Jesus. I guess even back then she was a jerk. Yeah, no kidding. Hey, sorry I'm late, she announced in the same perfectly gratingly cheerful voice she's had for the past 50 years. You didn't start eating without me, did you? How irritating. We'd never do that. Should I pour you a glass of wine? Asked Counselor Yang cloyingly, raising the pitcher in her direction. He's always been like this with her, ever since he inherited his council position. I can never tell if he understands the implication of her being an immortal computer program, or if he's just an idiot. Probably he's just an idiot. Okay, so no. She was an AI at this point. No photo on file for Yang, but he was the Counselor of Justice. Haha, man, I wish. With that sort of shit we've got to deal with, I sure could use it, she said with a slight flip of her golden hair. Then she turned to me. Anyway, Chief Counselor, I bet you're wondering why I asked you here, right? You said it was important, I said impatiently. It's about the Committee for Freer Democracy, she said, with appropriate scorn emphasizing their name. This week, Miss Hyo has literally done nothing but shut down their meetings. How many noise violation orders have you issued in the past 7 days? 10? Alright, her, Chief Security Officer. 15, said her lieutenant. It was a dramatic tactic on Mute's part, as if she didn't know exactly how many. My bad, she said. And every week, the number of private log entries using their keywords doubles. I'm worried we're going to be reaching a critical mass soon. At this rate, I'm worried that the presidential election results are going to lead to, like, public demonstrations. We can't deal with that. You're the Counselor of Security. It's your damned job to deal with it, I told her. I'm not interested in excuses. She's not making her lieutenant started, out of line, but Mute managed to muzzle her. Stand down, Miss Hyo, she told her. But then she turned to me with the same rudeness. Now listen here, young man. I was not like asking your approval. We have a problem, and a stern lecture from the Chief Counselor is not going to help, okay? You can blame me if you want, but that's not going to solve shit. Yang stifled a grin, thinking that I wasn't looking. I had to glare to put him back in line. Sheepishly, he took a large drink of his wine. I'd at least like to know why it is that you can't even do your job effectively, I demanded. At least show some respect. Okay, sure, you got it, sir, she said sarcastically, an impossible expression on her face. But I think, sir, you misunderstand what my job is. My job isn't to stop public demonstrations. My job is to make sure public demonstrations don't happen in the first place. Like, do you have any idea what happened the last time we had public demonstrations? She paused. She expected me to actually answer her question, prepared to pounce at the moment I got even the slightest detail wrong. I tried to recall, but she said something before I had the chance to say anything. She was sarcastic to men. Mute? Wow. That is actually surprising. Given Mute's attitudes, the fact that she would actually be so sarcastic and so scornful and frank with the Chief Counselor, that is really surprising. Anyway. No, of course you don't. It was like 4 centuries ago. They led to open armed rebellion. We're talking about outright banditry, okay? This is not tenable, sir, she said in a high and mighty way. Do you have any idea what martial law is like? Because that's what it took to crush it last time. So, interrupted Yang, you're saying that carrying out your job needs our help. You got it, counselor, she said. Look, there's no need for hostilities. Men, we've got a common problem here and I think we can sort it out. And really, Chief Counselor, in my opinion, as Counselor of Security, and as the eldest person around by like a millennium, I think we can sort this out, but I wouldn't have asked you here if I don't need your help. I sighed. She had a point. If I had to clean up what she couldn't, that's her job. What's your plan? You're not going to like it, she said, and I was sure I believed her. First, we let Park back in the presidential race. Okay, who's Park? First time we've read about this person. Is he being carried away in cuffs? It kind of looks like he is. First, we let Park back in the presidential race. That's what the agitators have been getting upset about, so we had to take the wind right out of their sails if we take away their main point of contention. That's madness. He's a radical, and he's very likely to be elected, I said. What's the worst that happens? We just veto the bastard down at every step. The president's powerless against the council in the end, Yang suggested. No good. I mean, you're right, but that'll just lead to more unrest, she said, shaking her head. What the hell do you propose, then? Just let him dictate his crazy, radical, anti-noble policies? I demanded. Yeah, actually. I think that's our best shot. Hear me out, okay? You resign as chief counselor, and don't give me shit here. I know you've been meaning to for ages. Don't pretend like you've been upset. You'd be upset for that to happen. We put in someone new, younger, as the face of the council. Say it's part of our new direction. The president's going to call for reforms, and we're going to let him. And our new direction will be going along with them. So we just yield to the madness of democracy, then? I said incredulously. She sounded absolutely insane, but of course, she had a plan. I'm pained to admit. No, that's crazy. Of course not, she said, and then she grinned madly. We pretend to. We are going to be the democracy movement's worst friend. If the president proposes reforms, yeah, we'll nod along. We'll say we'll do it. Then we'll water it down. We'll stall, cause, like, here's the thing. The people? They don't have specific demands. They're dumb. They're okay with compromises. All we have to do is make it look like they've won, and the movement loses all its momentum. And then, rebellion crushed, said her lieutenant, smashing her fist into her palm dramatically. Efficiently and subtly. You got it. Efficient and subtle. That's how we do it, said Mute. I wasn't sure at first what I thought of her plan. It's insane, for sure. It's incredibly bold. But the more I thought about it over dinner, I thought, maybe that's what we need. And all the time I've known Mute, she might try my patience, but I've never known her intentions to be misplaced. She might be chatty, and a gossip, and disrespectful, but one thing is for sure, she's honest and never manipulative. I think there's a reason why she came to my face and asked me this, when she could have just gone around me with the rest of the council. She might be a bitch at times, but she's still programmed to always act in the best interests of the ship's safety. Always. By the time we'd finished eating, I'd just about made up my mind. Who do you propose as the new face of the council, then? You? I asked. Ha! Oh, please, she shook her head dramatically. I said a younger face. Mine's as old as it gets. Only by choice, Yang said. You can always look as young and beautiful as you'd like. Yeah, sure. I've done that before. And when the fashions change, I'm sure I'll do it again, she started. I think you look fine the way you are, counselor, said Hyo, an odd tone to her voice. An odd tone to her voice. Well, she certainly looks... She's really different than the Mute I knew. Yeah, she certainly looks, dramatic. She looks downright murderous. Odd tone to her voice. It's not the point, okay? She shook her head, looking exacerbated. We need someone who's actually young, who the peasantry will trust as a being willing to accept new ideas. Counselor Lee, perhaps, I suggested. No vote on file. Counselor of Culture was from the Lee family, okay? No, definitely not. Too charismatic, too ambitious. That woman has got an agenda, and I do not trust it for a second, she said. She was probably right, on reflection. Counselor Yang, who would you suggest? Counselor of Justice was really friendly to Mute. He paused, then a flash of light seemed to go off behind his dim eyes. Counselor Ryu Hyun-su, he said, and give it to the useless figurehead, Counselor of Captaincy. He'll be so thrilled to actually have a real job, he'd never think to do anything with it. Wait, Ryu, as in Captain and Emperor Ryu? Counselor of Captaincy. You're right, she said. Of course, I said too. After a pause of reflection, He's young, completely malleable, but plausible as a reformer. As the face of impotent rebellion, Ryu would be perfect. That was where we left the discussion for the night. And now, I guess it's time to tell my wife that I'll finally be retiring. She'll be thrilled. Alright, so there's three more. 42, 42, 42. Fuck Hyo family gatherings. That one sounds really interesting. Daily reports. And Bao Yu and the mirror. Let's go with fuck Hyo family gatherings. Wow, this boy swears so much. Just judging by the title, I would agree. Holy crap, this is long. Wow. I like playing Huatu 2, though. The cards are pretty- Oh, she's commenting about something I didn't actually read yet. Hold on, I'll get there. I'm so sick of spending time with my extended family. I don't think I've ever met a single person who thinks these Hyo family gatherings are any fun. Everyone I've talked to seems to secretly hate them. I just realized I never clicked on his name. This is the first time we've read about this person. Oh my god, which... Let's smile. That's adorable, but, which one is he? Who are those people? I don't even know what I'm looking at. But that is freaking adorable, oh my god. Okay. Everyone I've talked to seems to secretly hate them, every single one. But we all pretend to care and take interest in how every random unimportant cousin has been doing. And who's just got married and who fucking cares about it all? This time, someone apparently paid serious money to hire an entire troupe of actors to perform short scenes in the living room, which at least shut down the conversation. Unfortunately, the performances were complete shit. I needed to get away and slipped out between sets under the pretense of trying to find the washroom, in the hopes of falling in and therefore having an excuse for not being around. Instead, while I was wandering the halls of the main branch's absurdly large home, I ended up stumbling on the weirdest scene, a table with a card game in progress on it, with an old professor of mine at one end and a mostly naked flat-chested maid sitting on strewn about clothes. Whoa. What? Hold on, let me read that again. A table with a card game in progress on it, with an old professor of mine at one end, and a mostly naked, flat-chested maid sitting on strewn about clothes. Were they playing strip poker, but without the poker? She calls it Huatu. Is it strip Huatu? As a professor, was Hyo So Young's husband? Okay. The maid. Sorry, I was, looking for the washroom, I said sheepishly, and started to back away. It wasn't even like the door was closed. I wasn't trying to sneak in anywhere. They were just there for anyone in the hall to see. Wait! Don't go, cute boy, the maid called out. Do you want to play Huatu? We could really use a third. Ooh, this is getting interesting. I hope that's actually pronounced Huatu. Even if it isn't, whatever. I'm probably mispronouncing everything, so add one more mispronunciation to the pot, and it really doesn't tip the scales in any particular direction. What am I even saying? Let's go. Is this okay? Is that okay? I asked, looking at the professor, terrified that I'd interrupted an intimate moment. Then I remembered the last time I'd visited their home looking for his wife, the chief security officer. Alright, that's his wife. Yep, chief security officer. And how he was indisposed then, too. That was a weird fucking night. Yes, if you have silver to play for, he said with a shrug. It really did seem like he didn't care. Sure, I said. Even then I got the feeling I was about to be hustled, but whatever. Anything to escape the family. I hear that, he said. Bloody in-laws. I'm a Hyo too, I said, then I introduced myself. You're Professor Kim, right? I had you in an Earth history class. I just realized the hilariousness of there being an Earth history class. Isn't that a strange thought? Earth history. Let me guess, first year? You and every other officer in your family, he said. Go ahead and deal, Mimi. Okay, so that is her... Oh, no, that's someone else. For some, you've read about this person. Damn, nice sense of fashion. That's really freaking cool looking, whatever he or she... I don't even know if that's a he or she. I think it might be a he, I'm not sure. Really freaking awesome fashion sense. Nice. I can't really give a play-by-play of the game itself, I don't really remember that well. It probably didn't help that after putting our silver for the stakes, Mimi kept pouring me more and more to drink. That's a really unusual name. Is it your real one? I asked the maid. The maid. Wait a minute. Hold on. You said an extremely flat-chested maid. A mostly naked, flat-chested maid sitting on strewn about clothes. Wait a minute. The fact that he's describing... The fact that he's describing him or her as flat-chested makes me think that he thinks she's a woman. But the fact that it kind of looks like a man in the picture and it's described as flat-chested, and she describes him or her as flat-chested makes me think maybe it's actually a man, but he thinks she's a woman, or... But wouldn't he know from talking to her? I'm confused now. What the hell is going on? So there's a maid that may be a man or maybe a woman, and she or he is, like, mostly naked, and they're playing a card game. What is going on? I'm so confused. I'm intrigued, though. Where was I? Oh, yes. That's a really unusual name. Is it your real one? I asked the maid. Nope, was the only response. I kept trying not to stare, and it wasn't working. Maybe that's what the nudity was for, to win at cards by means of seduction. I mean, man, it sure worked. It was pretty hard not to get caught up thinking about how soft that bare skin would feel against my hands, and instead worry about my hand in the game. It was also losing me a rapid number of points. At first, I didn't realize just how badly I was doing, because I assumed my real threat was the professor, and he always seemed to be at the same point I was. And Mimi was only whittling us down very slowly, never calling go no matter how big the lead was. The next thing I knew, we were both out. Oh wow, I won, Mimi exclaimed with a girlish giggle. I feel like I'm on a roll. How about another, but with higher stakes? A 5 silver per point? And that was the hustle. No bloody way, I know when I'm done, the professor said. I'm sitting this one out. I would be lying if I said the reason why I went in wasn't simply because I was attracted and wanted to spend more time with Mimi. I mean, I figured I'd be able to make back my money, because I couldn't really take that giggling very seriously, but mostly it was attraction. It ended pretty quickly. 3 rounds in, I had arrogantly raised the stakes, then promptly got utterly swept with a single play that took my opponent from 0 points to having more than enough to wipe me out, twice. Go or stop? I asked. Stop. That, puts me in an awkward position, I explained. If you do that, you'll win, and I'll be out. And I don't have anything more in my purse. But I'm having a lot of fun playing with you, so if you say go, we can take another few rounds. Nope, stop, was a response, followed by a cutesy head tilt. Then I watched as my money got swept off the table. I'm not playing for fun, I'm playing for money. You're vicious, I teased. I have to be, Mimi exclaimed. I've got tutors for my entrance exams to pay for, and I am but a poor little thing. The last word was dragged out. It was a little bit too cutesy. Tutors? The exams aren't that hard, I said. Huh. And when did you take them? 4,030? The professor scoffed. 37. I'm not that old, I said. So even then they were using Chinese characters. That's so stupid. Well, they were a lot easier then. Anyone could get in. How many Chinese characters do you know, kid? He asked, rolling his eyes at me. I thought back to school. He was actually my least favorite professor. I thought he was pretty obnoxious. I don't know. Not many, I admitted. Yeah, right. Nowadays, you need to know 1,000 in order to get in. Mind you, you'll have trouble in a lot of classic classes if that's all you know, but it's the bare minimum, he told me. Holy shit, I said. Yeah, well, that's what's important nowadays, he said. How's that? I couldn't imagine why. Don't ask me, he said. I'm a history professor. It's way out of my bloody field. I don't care about Confucius. If I had it my way, it'd still be like it was before. I see, I said. Hence all the tutors, Mibi said, pouring me another drink. Hey, how about another game? Okay, so hold on. This is, when were the last messages? This is at least a couple years, at least 3 years after the Education Amendment Act thing was passed, making it, I guess, mandatory to learn Chinese. So, and the fact that he needs to get, or he or she needs to, Mimi, needs to get money to be able to pay for tutors. So it's very, it's hard to learn, and it's very expensive if you want tutors. So it really is a very exclusive thing. It's only for the higher class. It's only for people with money. Yep, I definitely see that causing tons of social problems. Okay. Hey, how about another game? I think he's had enough to drink, the professor said. In retrospect, he was absolutely right. I'm fine. I can handle it, I said. Absolutely wrong. I'm in security. We drink pretty fucking hard. So my wife keeps complaining, he responded. Fine. If we're in the stupid part of the evening, I'll leave you two to it. Have fun, kids. He turned to look at Mimi. I'm going to go find the maid you swindled that uniform from, since half the work's done for me. Give it back when you're done. Yes, sir, Mimi responded. Wait, so Mimi stole the maid uniform? From the maid? Oh, that completely went over my fucking head at the time, on account of the drinking. I just realized right now. The joke was that Mimi had stolen the maid's clothes, and their rightful owner was presumably naked somewhere. Holy fucking yikes, man, I totally did not get that at the time. Wow, yeah, he had been drinking to not get that. So, what? Why? Why did he or she swindle the maid's clothes? What the fuck is going on? This is so bizarre. So he or she is in the maid's clothes, or at least a little bit in the maid's clothes, mostly naked, and the actual maid is somewhere naked? Like, what? What is going on? Anyway, then I was alone, for which I was kind of glad, because it gave me a chance to get closer. So, another game? Mimi asked. My purse is empty. I've got nothing, I said. Play just for fun? I only play for keeps. How about I loan you back the 600 silver you just lost? Even I could tell that this was a bad idea at this point. Too bad my dick couldn't, and it was what was making decisions for me at that point. I'll need to take something as collateral. What? I asked, far too quickly. A kiss, Mimi responded, smiling coyly at me, a finger against the lips. I was wrapped around that finger at this point. Ah, jeez, what is he saying? To make a long story short, I naturally agreed, and the kiss that was taken from me was amazing. You know, the kind that just makes you want more and more and frustrates you. That was the point, I have no doubt. It fucking well worked. I didn't want to win back my money. That was just money. I wanted to win Mimi. Anyway, I sure didn't win back the money. I was cleaned out in 10 minutes. Well, I'm off, Mimi said, starting to pull the strewn clothes into something more proper-like. Wait, I said, not actually having a follow-through. It's cute in a way, I suppose. Is this how adults are? I just stared for a moment, trying to think of something. How am I going to pay you back? How do I pronounce that? Hyo-sung-bok? I'm gonna go with that. Hyo-sung-bok. I'm sure I can find you. Wait a minute, Isn't that Mimi? That's gotta be Mimi. Hold on. It's like an armband. That's a scarf. That's gotta be Mimi. Yes, that's Mimi in the picture. That is so adorable. Oh my god. Look at that. Cuteness overload again. I love this game. How about I pay you with dinner sometime? I asked. Mimi laughed. Cute boy, you know I'm not a girl, right? He asked. They're both boys. Wow. Okay, I thought so. Do you think I would have let you kiss me if you were? I asked. I thought it was the coolest fucking line at the time. It wasn't. True, but definitely not fucking cool. You're funny, he said. I'll see you around. I sure hope so. After he left, I stumbled back out to the main party, thankfully to discover that the actors were done and that there was now food to be had, which I sure needed. I really couldn't get that card-hustling boy and the sight of his really gorgeous body and that kiss out of my head. Still can't. Eventually, the family members just stopped bothering me because I was pretty clearly spaced out by thinking of him. I only feel a little bit bad. If I'm going to get played, man, it could be a lot worse than by someone like that. A lot worse. Damn, I sure hope I see him again. Well, judging by the picture, I would say he did see him again. I can't get over how adorable that picture is. Oh my god. Okay, what's next? I'm glad I picked that one. That was awesome. Alright, two more. So that was about 4 years after the amendment of the Education Act. Daily report or this? Let's go with this. Daily report for March 15th. 4042 by Hyo-seo-young. I don't know. Well, who's that again? Okay, yeah. Seo-young. I have absolutely nothing to report today. The Mugunghwa Flower Festival is still utterly boring, and I still do not enjoy the celebrations. The plaza was peaceful, zero arrests were needed, and a decreased security presence shipwide has led to no negative ramifications. My cruel boss still... Wait, who's the boss? Oh, you're right. It's mute. Still makes me write these things even if nothing of note happens, though, so here I am filling up space out of boredom. I've noticed that Mute has updated her appearance again recently. There's a lot more silver hair mixed in with her blonde, and she's been wearing it short. And I'm really enjoying her new suits that seem to be all about narrow-waisted vests instead of jackets. It cuts a strong silhouette, and it feels really intimidating. I'm so happy to see her dressed like that. When the fashion lately has been for women to wear long dresses and seem less imposing, she's really done the opposite. Yeah, she certainly looks badass there. I mean, damn. If I saw her looking like that, I would not want to mess with her. I think she's the most gorgeous she's ever looked, gray hair and all. I mean, I always feel outclassed. Oh, that sounds like a really good outfit. I approve. Me too. I mean, I've always felt outclassed by her, and I know she's got 1,600 years on me. But I'm glad she's starting to look older at the same time I'm feeling it. I wonder how often she changes her visual age. Regardless, she makes it look so good. She's been doing this thing lately, where she'll light a cigarette by snapping her fingers, then blow smoke at dramatic moments and say something like, "Just watch me." And it's enough to make even the coolest of people's hearts skip a beat. And that is my report for today. Skip a beat, huh? Okay, well, they're obviously in love with each other. Oh dear. Do not ever do this again, Seo Young. It is embarrassing on every level and not the point of daily reports. I will replace you with a large potted houseplant if you ever turn in a report this unprofessional again, okay? Oh my god, that's adorable. How can Mute be such a piece of shit and yet cute at the same time sometimes? I mean, this is adorable, but we can't forget she was spearheading, or at least supporting, an attempt to keep the peasants ignorant. I mean, that is disgusting, but this is adorable. Ah. Well, I can see that she wasn't the only one in love with a certain AI. Oh, hey, Hyun-ae. How are you doing? Okay. One more. Bao Yu? I'm gonna go with Bao Yu. Yeah? I don't know, I'm not gonna get stuck with the pronunciation too much. Again with all the swearing. Oh, is this... Oh, it's him again! He was a really young security officer. I don't really get it. Yeah, wait a minute, he was a security officer? I mean, he looks like 18. Damn. Ooh, there's another long one. This is gonna be fun. Okay. I knew that boy was cruel, but man, I didn't realize just how bad he was. What a fucker. Mimi was a man who was really good at playing cards. He sounds really dreamy. He doesn't just sound dreamy, he looks dreamy. Oh my god, he oozes... Something about the way he looks. He just oozes sexiness and coolness in, like, every freaking way. I mean, damn. Anyway. So, this happened last weekend. I went over to his family place in the plaza at midday. The front area was all but empty. I think there may have been a customer or two at the time, but only the sort who are actually there for food. I don't know why, the food is awful. Hey, I'm going into the back to see him, I said to Mimi's mother, who was behind the counter. Fuck off, the cranky old crone said. Whoa, holy shit. It sounds like they've never really met before. She just said fuck off? To a security officer? Damn. Okay, so it's pretty obvious that at this point in time, the society was not... It either wasn't patriarchal or it wasn't as patriarchal, I'm not sure which. Because in Analog A Hate Story, there is no way the women would have talked to men this way. No way. No way in hell would anyone say fuck off to a man. That would be so unbelievable. But back in this time, yeah, it looks like everything was very different. Sure thing, I said. I don't really... Oh, wait. Hold on. I just realized something. Mute was expressing surprise... not Mute. Hyun-ae was expressing surprise that Mute would talk to a man in the way she did. I just realized she has the same perspective on this that I do, in the sense that she doesn't know what happened either. So it's a surprise to her to see women talking to men like this. Because she has no experience with that. Her only experience is with all the logs from everything since day zero, or year zero. Which is what I have experience with too, which is where everything was incredibly patriarchal and something like that could have never even been thought about. I just realized that. Anyway. Sure thing, I said. I don't really bother arguing with her, because who cares, at the end of the day, I've still taken her son as a lover. Wait, is this... Wait, I've taken her son as a lover. Let me check the dates on this. Pardon, can we talk? No, hold on, I'm not done. What was the last one? July, December. Okay, so a bit of time has passed. Okay. That's his phrasing, by the way, not mine. I would have just said I was banging him, but he told me, I like the sound of taking so-and-so as a lover. I want to be taken as a lover. Taken. And that's the kind of possessiveness I like the sound of. I don't really get it, and also I don't really think anyone would believe that I'm the one doing the taking. Sure, I'm taller and manlier and the noble, but he is a domineering little man in comparison to me. But if he says he likes something, then I'll do it. So he's been taken by me as a lover. I don't really think the idea of being taken is as romantic as he says. Yeah. Especially since where she grew up, women were just kind of given as just like cattle, like given as cattle, just like pawns. And they had no choice in the matter of... It actually had nothing to do with romance. It was just pure marriage, arranged marriages. So yeah, Taken definitely would not sound romantic to her, and in fact, it doesn't even really sound romantic to me. But anyway. Anyway, so I walked into the perfectly legal, friendly gambling room in the back. He wasn't playing, he was studying at the computer, which isn't really weird or anything, but he seemed to be studying together with some other man, which surprised me. I mean, I wasn't jealous or anything. Well, fine. Maybe a little. I mean, he does flirt with a lot of men and women, but I don't care about that, because he's trying to get money out of them. But I know I'm special. Or at least, hope that I'm special. Honestly, though, I was mostly just surprised at that point. The flirting with other men is only while playing cards, and studying together is our thing. I said hi to Mimi, he turns around to wave at me, and the other guy turns around and... Look, this is important, I swear. He looks just like me. It's fucking uncanny, okay? Holy shit, that is weird. Looks like you. Studying hard? I asked Mimi. Still classic literature. The one you said last week was so easy when you did it, he said, affecting a pout. It was cute, although I worried, rightly, that I had actually hurt his feelings. I've been really struggling, so I'm taking a break from gambling to dedicate myself to my studies. In retrospect, the idea of him taking a break from gambling should have been the giveaway, but I'm dumb, apparently. It should have been the giveaway. The giveaway of what? Well, apparently I'm dumb too, because I don't get it. Taking a break from gambling is a giveaway. He's been doing pretty well, though. I'm proud of him, his friend said. Want to take a break to go out for dinner? I offered. You're welcome to come too, I trailed off. Sorry, I don't think I caught your name. You two don't know each other already? I would have thought, since you're both... Mimi said, surprised. Huh? Both what? I asked, confused. You're both from the Hyo family, he said. You've really never met? No, I said, earnestly surprised. I stared, trying to figure out if I'd seen him before, but I couldn't remember seeing him at any family gatherings. That didn't really mean a whole lot, though, because seriously, fuck Hyo family gatherings. I pay as little attention as I possibly can to them. I don't think I could name half my cousins, truthfully. Were you at the last family gathering? I wasn't, unfortunately. I was ill, he said. Fair enough. But I'm Hyo Seung Bok. It's nice to meet you. What's your name? My jaw dropped. That's his name. What? Hyo Seung Bok. Hyo Seung Bok. I'm Hyo Seung Bok. What the fuck? What? My jaw dropped. Huh? I'm Seung Bok. What's your name? He repeated. It's also Seung Bok, I stammered. Nice to meet you. Anyway, boy, I can't do dinner out. Too poor, we could eat out in front, though, Mimi suggested, meaning his mother's restaurant, which is basically worse than dying. Well, thinking about it right now, maybe it's not actually shit food. Maybe she just has it out for me. Man, fuck, that's totally it, isn't it? Anyway, it didn't seem like a good idea. I'll cover it, don't worry about it, I insisted. For both of you, let's just get out of here. Well, fine, Mimi shrugged. We went to the place across from his, which is decent enough. So are you also in security? I asked the other Seung Bok. Yes, of course, he said. I'm the second lieutenant of Deck 10, actually. Yourself? I felt really humbled being way the fuck outranked by this guy. Just a lowly officer on the plaza, sir. Oh, there's no need to sir me, he smiled. Are you all right? You're staring. Mimi laughed, prodding at me from under the table. I'm fine, just a little surprised is all, I lied. Honestly, it was kind of freaking me the fuck out. We talked more, even after we finished dinner, and frankly, I just got more and more alarmed by how much we had in common past the whole name thing. I mean, the name thing was weird. Neither of the characters in mine are really common at all, and it turned out he even wrote them the same way as mine. And he ordered the same food as me right before I did. And was the same age, which made me feel pretty shitty about my own accomplishments, let me tell you. Men or women? I asked. Women, he answered. Definitely women. Well, finally, there's a difference, I said. Exasperatedly, there we go. Boom! Knocked it out of the park. I'm proud of myself for that. Ahem, Mimi cleared his throat conspicuously. Well, except for him, he's cute enough that anyone can make an exception for him. The other Seong Bok said, looking at him. Uh-oh. I was thinking that maybe studying together with Seong Bok could be a regular thing, Mimi said, making flirty eyes, not in my direction. I'd like to get through a Dream of the Red Chamber together with him, at the very least, since he's read it. So have I stammered, awkwardly trying to fight for his attention, because I'm an idiot. Well, we've just gotten to chapter... XX? Does that mean that has Roman numerals, like 20? Or... I don't know. Anyway, where Bao Yu sleeps in front of the mirror, remember? Mimi smiled. Besides, don't you think it would be nice, me being together with Seong Bok and Seong Bok? I wouldn't have to take up so much of your time, so you could focus more on exams, so you could get promoted. I just gaped in horror at his proposal, as if he could fucking suggest such an awful thing. I wanted to spend more time with him, not less. And it was just... fuck the thought that I was basically replaceable in his eyes. I've been worried about that in our relationship, but I was just some interchangeable noble in his eyes, and this was just making that all worse. I really don't think, that's just kind of... I stammered, something like that. I can't remember the exact wording. Mimi, I don't want to be replaced with some mere version of me. That's... And then I stopped mid-sentence. Do you think he's figured it out yet? The mirror song Seong Bok asked him, trying to stifle laughter. I can't keep this up anymore. I told you he hadn't read it, Mimi said enthusiastically. You're fucking with me, I finally said. A little, Mimi said. Come on, Dream of the Red Chamber. You were supposed to have studied literature as part of becoming an officer. The mirror Song Bok, Seong Bok, said to me, suddenly switching to a lot less stilted voice. You don't remember the part where Bao Yu meets the other Bao Yu? The thing we spent the past hour reenacting? I was never really good with classical literature, I admitted. Oh, I thought it seemed unbelievable. So did I. But then again, you came from what was described as an egg. A stasis egg that someone cracked to bring you out of stasis, so... I don't know, crazy stuff has happened before, Hyun-ae, but yeah. It did seem a bit ridiculous. See? I'm right, aren't I? Mimi asked, looking at the mirror Seong Bok expectantly. Well, alright. Fine, Mimi, he said, reaching into his purse and putting down money on the table. Like I said before, of course it couldn't be true that Mimi was taking a break from gambling. Oh, that's what he meant. Who's a giant fucking idiot? This guy. I cracked up before he figured it out. You win. I'm speechless. But how's it done? Then he said goodbye and left. Fucking hell, I can't believe you'd do that to me, I yelled at him, honestly upset. Mimi, you giant fucking cock. Mimi got up and came over to my side of the table, sitting next to me. Well, you're an idiot for believing it, he said, wrapping his arm around my shoulder. I was upset at him, but I have a hard time saying no to physical comfort from him. Even when I think he's an asshole. He... really swears so much. Yes, he does. Then he looked at me very suddenly and intensely and said, there's no such thing as mirror versions of someone. There's no such thing as someone out there who is like you, except more desirable. You're special to me, and I can't believe you're actually stupid enough to think I could find any way to replace you at all. There's no such thing as someone who I'd love in the way I love you. Am I perfectly clear? Yeah, I croaked. I felt pretty humbled and touched. Still upset. But mostly touched. It was sweet, in his own awful way. I don't get the relation at all. If you're not too mad at me, I'm going to kiss you now, and it's going to make me really happy. Because you're special and have a good... and have a good taste and are someone I love, he said, leaning close. If that's all right with you. Yeah, it is, I reluctantly said. Cruel fucker. Oh, that was kind of cruel, but oh my god, that was so sweet. This whole thing, there's no such thing as someone who I'd love in the way I love you, am I perfectly clear? To think of that and then look at this picture.
It's so adorable! Oh my god.
That's like the most adorable picture I've ever seen. I love this game. Christine loves games, they're just filled with so much love and so much hate at the same time. It's funny. Okay, well, that is the last message. Let's look at that one more time. Okay, that is the last message. Oh yeah, she wants to talk. What is up, Hyun-ae, my scientist extraordinaire investigatling partner person AI? We've been reading together for a while, haven't we? Let's take a break.
Sounds good to me.
Are you up for that? Hell yes! What do you have in mind?
Ah, great.
We can, I don't know, what can we do? Unfortunately, I still can't talk to you in a normal way. So, I don't know. What do you have in mind? So, right. This is sort of something that's been on my mind lately, the idea of having a body. Okay, I was thinking about that, especially given the brochure I found in my mail. Actually, before I continue, I will be right back. Okay, I am back. Alright, so what have you been thinking about, Hyun-ae? The idea of having a body. I always thought, when I was alive and sick, that I'd love to be free of it. That it'd be great to be free of all its stupid fragility. Then I spent 600 years alone in my own mind, and I just, well, I feel so isolated. I mean, I have a computer simulation of arms and legs and a face, so I don't go mad, but it's been so exciting to finally be able to interact with a person I love, don't get me wrong. I just really miss, well, touch. Especially while reading about things like Hyo Young's going on fancy political dinners. I mean, you travel alone, so you have a little bit of an idea. Don't you ever feel really strongly sometimes that you just want a nice hug?
Yes.
Definitely. I thought so. I really want to hug you too. I wish I could. Do you think it wouldn't be possible for me to get a body on Earth? Definitely. I mean, looking at the mail, obviously, yeah, they exist. Ah, that's a relief. That would be so nice to have. I just keep thinking. I don't even remember what it feels like anymore. I don't remember touch at all. And, you know, I really love being able to interact with you, talk with you. But I just feel like, well, I want to kiss you. maybe this is inappropriate, but I'd kind of like, jeez, this is hard to say. I really want to kiss you. Yep, those aren't even words. I'm just like giggling. I've never done that before, but I really feel like I want to, jeez, what an embarrassing thing to be saying. It's okay, Hyun-ae. No need to be embarrassed. Is that something you're fine with? Yes, I'd love to, too. Oh, gosh, then. I bet it would be really nice. I bet it would be, too. Kissing you while you touch my hair. I've been thinking about those kinds of things, just a little. It's okay if you think about them a lot. I'm okay with that. Maybe, though, actually, this is embarrassing, too. We could hug. And you could touch my hair? Well, yeah, wait, you mean like right now, or what? Yes? Oh, well, that's good. I don't even remember the feeling of that anymore, but I know it was really comforting. I wonder, what would it be like to have hair again? Could it be blown in the wind? Would it be fluffy? It makes me think of Ryu Chehua, my husband's wife. She'd comfort me and brush my hair. But when I try to think about it, I just don't remember what it felt like to be touched like that. I really want to, though. I don't want to be stuck behind a computer screen forever. I want to remember what it's like to be touched. Okay, wait, so can I extract more documents right now? I think I can, right? Can I do 6 more? You know, let me do an emergency diagnostic. I don't think I need to do that. I'm pretty sure I don't need to do that, but no. Nah. I don't think I need to do that unless something's wrong. Alright. I'll extract new messages. Alright, do I have 6 more? Yes, I do. Okay. I really don't know what order to go in. Hmm.